In this video, I'm going to tell you why I personally stopped using Canva and started using Adobe Express. Hi everyone, I'm Andrew Kahn and I used to work at TubeBuddy where I grew their YouTube channel from about 6,000 subscribers to over 500,000. During that time, I used a lot of different softwares to help create YouTube thumbnails, including TubeBuddy's own free YouTube thumbnail generator. Since that time and after, I would use design softwares like Canva. If you don't know what Canva is a free graphic designer that you can use on your mobile device or on your desktop. Similarly, Adobe Express lets you do that too. You can use it on your mobile phone or desktop and really design anywhere. Now, in full disclosure, I am an Adobe Express ambassador, but before I was even an ambassador, I made videos about Adobe Express and even mentioned this.
Since I've seen many other YouTubers and influencers say Canva's easier than Photoshop and you'll never need Photoshop again, I can see why Adobe wanted to create their own browser-based designer. So look, however you feel about Adobe's Creative Cloud Express, one thing is true. The competition between Adobe and Canva offers us as creators more free tools.
Now, I never got to that Canva video, and the reason is I really never was the right fit for Canva. Let me explain. My biggest issue with Canva is, while it's a great software, it just wasn't the right tool for me. And if you've been watching my content for any amount of years, you'd know that one of my signature phrases, use what works best for you. And for me, Canva wasn't what was working best. Transparently, I was using Photoshop until I saw Adobe Express one day. I was scrolling through Twitter, saw an ad for it, and I thought, this looks interesting. So I gave Adobe Express a try. What I didn't like about Canva, I was starting to like in Adobe Express, and let me explain. As a longtime Photoshop user, one of the things I liked the most about Adobe Express is just how integrated it already was with the Creative Cloud suite that I've been using for years. My libraries, my fonts, all of the things I had saved within the Adobe Cloud was already there and ready for me to go in Adobe Express. Compare that to using Canva, I'd have to manually bring it over every time, anytime it was on a new team, anytime I was working in a new project, and it just became tiresome. Now, I am sure there are ways to remedy that, but for me, I was really only using Canva when my clients wanted me to, not because I liked it personally. But with Adobe Express, a lot of my clients were already using the Adobe Creative Cloud, and one of the benefits of Express is it does have a free version, but it also has a paid version that's included in the Creative Cloud, so a lot of my clients already had it, and I was already more familiar with it than Canva. On top of that, I really like what Adobe's doing with Express. I think some of the tools they've come out with, such as the scheduler, the font suggestion feature, and even just the palette tools and free color options they provide is really more in my speed than it was when I was using Canva. Now, they are similar in the fact that they have a lot of templates, and to Canva's point, it has been around longer, and so it does have more templates. I find that the templates that Adobe Express has, I tend to use more personally. Another thing I like about Adobe Express is its vast use of the Adobe Stock library. There are so many images that have been uploaded and approved for use, whether you're both on the free or the paid version, and for me and my clients, one thing that my good friend Rob Balasabas said is that there is such a diverse amount of stock photos. There's not just people that look like me.
The other thing, on a personal note, when it comes to Adobe Stock images, is that there's a lot of amazing images that are very diverse, all right? I'm Filipino, I'm Asian, and they have a lot of images that are very diverse, all right? From, you know, people, from all sorts of backgrounds and ethnicity, and it's just a really good representation of the world here inside of Adobe Express, all right?
And that's important to me because as I'm designing, I don't want it just to be of my reflection. I want it to be a reflection of everyone who is out there and everyone I can work with and should work with. And that was a huge leg up for me with Adobe Express. The final nail in the coffin for Canva for me was really that ability to use Adobe Express because it's already included in the Creative Cloud. And for my clients who really weren't using Canva for anything more than graphics, Adobe Express covered all of their needs and more. And for me, I want to be able to teach you watching something that you can elevate your skills with over time. Whether you're a beginner or an advanced user, Adobe Express has a pathway for you. Not saying that Canva doesn't, but I have friends who create Canva content, and one of the questions they always get asked is, when should I move to Photoshop? That's not something I want to be able to say with a product. With Adobe Express, there are already built-in ways that you can learn the skills in Express and then take it over. And I think that upgrade path is so important. But hey, that's just my opinion. You know, I always say use what tool works best for you. So if Adobe Express is the tool for you, let us know in the comments. Or if you think Canva's a little bit better, let me know too. If you want to get started using Adobe Express, check out that video on screen for 5 beginner-friendly features that you can start creating content with today. Ultimately, Adobe Express got me excited for creating graphics again. And that is priceless for me. So, with that said, I'm Andrew Cannon. If I can use Adobe Express to create YouTube art, then you can too.